she aspires to discover and invent new techniques to make better use of waste. Let's welcome the founder of Cancel Plans, Mallika Reddy.
Thank you so much for having me. It's really my pleasure to be here and be talking to you about this.
What inspired you to start Cancel Plans, especially such a unique brand?
So yeah, I lived in a number of different cities across the world. I lived in LA, I went to college there, studied architecture. Post that, I was in Dubai for a couple of years, then I was in London for a couple of years, then I was in Bombay, and then back to Hyderabad. So yeah, it's been quite a journey. I think also it gave me a lot of exposure to see everything that's happening in the world.
You are using rejected materials which otherwise would have ended up in landfills, and you're making these wonderful, you know, garments, and you're making accessories. How did you think of using the waste?
So actually, I spent about maybe 6-7 months just kind of researching what I wanted to do. I didn't kind of dive into it. I knew that the waste problem was something that I think even for us in India, it's very evident. It's in front of our faces. There's piles and piles of trash everywhere. So it's like something that you look at it and you're like, what can I do about this? Then we also collect from this billboard printing factory.
I think I have a bag that you
yes,
sent me.
Yes, yeah, you have one, you have one. So that is... So that also similar, where we get a lot of blank, black and white, because they print something and they cut off the edges, and then there's nothing that you can do much with that. But it's very durable material.
Right.
Absolutely, we can use this waste to make so many things. So I don't want to stop here. I want to go into every industry and try to make something there.
Name a few. So, I'm so intrigued. Like, you know, I know bags and clothes. Then what else?
So we are working on a few collaborations as well.
Okay.
And I'm doing something with a home decor brand. So there's going to be like upholstery made from waste. There's going to be mats, carpets, coasters, everything, the works.
But did you have to motivate them, because they're not used to doing this kind of work? And it's very difficult. Me being a designer myself. Anything out of the normal, anything unconventional, takes them time to come around, and you need to constantly let them know the philosophy of your brand and drive them. So did you have to constantly encourage them, drive them, or motivate them?
Absolutely. I mean, it ranges from like begging and pleading and saying like please, 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 to being very adamant saying I want it, I know you can do it.
You're giving new life to waste materials and taking them to people's wardrobes. How do you feel about it?
Absolutely. It's very, very, very gratifying. I think also, I'm quite proud to say that our clothes are pretty comfortable too, considering where they come from. And people want to wear them, which is very, very nice.
We heard that you were the finalist at the Circular Design Challenge. Please talk a little more about it.
This year, actually in February, it was February 13th, was Sustainable Day at the Lakme Fashion Week. And every year they have the Circular Design Challenge, which is hosted by R. Elan from Reliance.
Okay.
And the UN.
Are you sending your merchandise out of country?
Yeah, right now we are stocked in a store in New York.
Okay.
And in Amsterdam as well. Yeah.
Oh, wow. That's interesting.
Thank you so much for having me, first of all. It's been really, really nice to talk to you. And I think you're doing such important work is to get so many voices out there.
Thank
so
you.
Thank you.
So we have a small token of gratitude for you, Mallika. This is a hamper, extremely healthy and nourishing, from Nourish You.
Thank you so much.